For those of you who are not familiar with the ring application's motion sensitivity and motion frequency setting, here is what it looks like. On this page, there's a screenshot on the left of the motion sensitivity screen, and on the right, the motion frequency screen. We start with motion sensitivity. On your mobile phone app, you will be able to select sensitivity from max down to minimum simply by using your mouse to drag the button left or right to any position you want. My guess of what this setting does is, at maximum, the infrared emitters on the camera would be at full power. This would mean that objects further away will receive infrared and hence be able to be detected by the camera. At minimum setting, my guess is the power of the infrared emitters is the lowest. This means that detection distance is reduced. For motion frequency, there are three settings, the lowest of which is periodically, which therefore provides maximum battery life. Then at the middle, it is regularly, which provides medium battery life. And finally, there's frequently, which provides the shortest battery life. Continue with me in this video as I explain to you what the technical definition of these three settings are in terms of scan and sleep period time cycles. This is based on written information I obtained from Ring Technical Support. In my phone call to Ring Technical Support, I pressed them to provide me technical definition of what the three settings for the motion frequency are, because Ring does not publish the definition of the scan and sleep period cycle, and without that technical definition, neither I nor anyone else can actually understand what those three settings mean. So Ring messaged me with written information about what the three settings are. Follow me and I will explain to you what they are. The lowest setting is called periodically. It operates a 2 to a 10 to a 30 minute sleep period cycle. This means that when motion is detected, after motion stops, it begins a 2-minute sleep period. After the sleep period, the camera wakes up and scans for motion for 1 minute. If motion is not detected, the process resets and begins a 10-minute sleep period. After the sleep period, the camera wakes up, scans for motion for 1 minute. If motion is not detected, the process resets and begins a 30-minute sleep period. Steps 5 and 6 repeat indefinitely as long as motion is not detected. Means that motion detection takes a long break after each motion. That is why this setting results in the longest battery life. The second setting is called regularly. It operates a 1 minute to 5 to 15 minute sleep period cycle. This means that when motion is detected, after motion stops, it begins a 1 minute sleep period. Then it wakes up, scans for motion for 1 minute. If motion is not detected, the process resets and begins a 5-minute sleep period. After which it wakes up, scans for motion for 1 minute. If motion is not detected, the process resets and begins a 15-minute sleep period. Steps 5 and 6 repeat indefinitely as long as motion is not detected. Means motion detection takes a break after each motion. And that is why this setting results in a medium battery life. So finally, several months after I've installed all my Ring devices, I now understand what these motion frequency settings actually are. The first Ring device I ever installed was the Ring Doorbell 4. And I had initially set motion frequency to regularly. And when I tested it standing in front of the doorbell for about 1 to 2 minutes, walking in front of it, 1 meter away from the camera, I was very surprised that it did not detect my presence. So I figured that regularly had a long sleep period. So from that day on, I set my doorbell and all my cameras to the highest motion frequency, which is called frequently. The last setting, frequently, operates a 0 minute to 0 to 0 minute sleep period cycle, means by default this setting will react to each motion it detects as a separate event. There is no sleep period with this setting. Absolutely wonderful. Motion detection always stays active, and this is why this setting results in the shortest battery life. To never miss any motion events, my Ring Doorbell 4 and all my stick-up battery cameras are set to motion frequency equal to frequently and sensitivity equal to max. Therefore, it's important to connect ring battery cameras to solar panels so that the batteries can be recharged. The new model 5F80E9 solar panel with 4W 5V DC are more powerful at charging than the old V4, which is 2.4W 5V DC model. So if you can install the new models or have to replace the old with the new, it is a better option. Now that you and I know the definitions of the three motion frequency settings, frequently, regularly, and periodically, I can see why Ring does not make this technical information public. And I can also understand why some Ring users will be surprised why their cameras and doorbells are not detecting any motion when they're standing right in front of it. For myself, I will always have the settings set frequently because I want to catch every motion. I want to know who has come to my front door each and every time. I hope this information helps you. I do hope you enjoyed this video and found it useful. Do hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more and to help the channel grow. Thank you so much.